Welcome to the journey. Today we're going to talk about how to get Pinterest followers for your business. Social media has become vital for any business or organization that wants to promote their brand and engage with their customers, but it's not just about Facebook. Twitter and Instagram, believe it or not, depending on your business, gaining Pinterest followers is important as well.
And it's more than just recipes and wedding planning. If you're looking to reach a wider customer base, build your authority and brand, increase your website traffic, establish expertise, connect with customers, or track new trends, Pinterest is the place for you.
Yeah, and if you're exploring how to use Pinterest as part of your marketing efforts, but you're not sure where to start, not to worry. We'll walk you through a few strategies to boost your Pinterest followers, starting with how to get started marketing on Pinterest. Now, Pinterest SEO is a long game. The more great content you create, curate, and pin, the more rewards you'll reap via sales through Pinterest and organic traffic to your site.
And if you haven't already, create a business account. When you create your Pinterest account, make sure it's a business account. You'll also verify your website and install a Pinterest save button so visitors can pin content from your site directly to their own boards.
Now it's on to creating compelling original images. And there is a definite lack of original images on Pinterest, I'll tell you that. So to boost your repins, post original imagery like photographs and infographs. However, remember that repinning original images isn't enough. They need to be high quality, attention grabbing images. Choosing photos with Pinterest in mind is definitely the way to go. So consider whether each photo to be pinned is engaging and interesting. And take time to ensure that there's something eye-catching about it, about your image. And even if that necessitates reshoots, it's worth it in the end. Dark or grainy photos will immediately deter your audience, so be sure all your images posted on Pinterest are bright and crisp.
And yeah, images are absolutely important, but writing captivating pin descriptions is just as important. A strong image on Pinterest just is not enough. You need that great description to match. And if you're aiming to craft compelling pin descriptions, there are just a few considerations to keep in mind. First, add text overlays in your pins to detail any special features in your pinned product. And then you need to make your description detailed. You can include up to 500 characters on Pinterest, and the site recommends that you add as much helpful information as you can. However, as the first 50 to 60 characters are the only ones that are likely to show in people's feeds, these are characters that are arguably matter the most. With that in mind, in your intro, focus on what is most relevant to your audience.
Totally, and Pinterest advises that you use complete sentences, relevant keywords, and a call to action, that CTA. In your CTA, feature action verbs such as see, shop, find, and buy, so your visitors know what you want them to do next.
Absolutely. Now let's talk about keywords and hashtags. So when writing your descriptions, add your carefully researched keywords along with a quick reason Pinterest users should want to learn more about your products and services. Optimizing your pins with keywords help your pins show up in search engines, driving Pinterest followers to you naturally without you having to search for them.
Keep it organic. You'll want to include both keywords and relevant search terms. If you need some help with this, use Pinterest search tool for details on the top searches and most relevant keywords. I know that helps me a lot when trying to find which hashtags to use on social media as well. And while you're optimizing your descriptions, don't overlook your images. Optimize the alt text of your images and your profile to further increase the chances of your content being found.
And as for hashtags, Pinterest is not a social media platform that responds to hashtags for keywords. So with Pinterest, the proper technique is to simply use the keywords in your pinned description. So no hashtags there.
One of the easiest ways to gain Pinterest followers is to add social sharing icons to your website. And when you do this, it makes it far easier for visitors to share your content. You can easily add sharing icons to your website by adding Pinterest save button and including it in the images and product lines on your website or blog.
And now Pinterest offers two save buttons, an automatic button or a hover button. Use whichever one best suits your needs. But once a Pinterest user has pinned your content, their followers will get to see it, helping to give your pin a wider reach and gain more impressions, hopefully getting you more Pinterest followers in the long run.
Yeah, hopefully. And another benefit of adding the save button is that you can use it alongside Pinterest analytics. And this is really cool. It allows you to determine your most popular content so that you can create more of it. And finally, to reach an even wider audience, share your pins on other social media sites like Facebook and Twitter.
Now, this next way goes with a lot of different platforms, but cross-promote pins in your other content. So include recent Pinterest links in your newsletters, email signatures, maybe even an IG story or a tweet. Doing that along with a strong call to action gives you the best chance at as many eyeballs in your content as possible.
And be sure to follow your competitors' followers. Might sound backwards at first, but although it won't always be the case, often if you follow someone, guess what? They're gonna follow you back. And an easy way to approach this is to find competitors' profiles. For example, if you write about arts and crafts, search under this term, then choose the people option, and this will bring you to a list of all their competitors, and you can look at your competitors' profiles, find out who their Pinterest followers are, and then follow them.
And then to further increase your followers, you must share content that will interest them. You can do this by looking at what your content competitors are sharing and what is getting the most interest. The more repins it has, the more likely it is to resonate with your audience.
And now there's no denying Pinterest's success. And with such a vast audience of active users, there's ample opportunity there for you to engage with your Pinterest followers and promote your content. However, to ensure your content is seen by as many visitors as possible, you need to introduce some effective strategies to build your Pinterest followers.
This includes using keywords to make your content easier to find, adding share buttons to your website, and being consistent. With all the strategies detailed in this video, you've got the know-how to get more Pinterest followers and reach a wider audience.
All right, that's a wrap. You just learned how to get Pinterest followers for your business. Be sure to comment below and subscribe to our channel.
Hey, don't forget to ring that bell so you get these episodes first. This is The Journey. We'll see you next time.